brethren, I pray you sing to the Lord a new song. Sing praise in the assembly of the righteous. Let the saints be joyful in glory. Let them sing aloud on their beds. Let the high praise of God be on the mouths of the saints, and a two-edged sword in their hands to execute vengeance on the demonic nations and punishments on those peoples, to bind their kings with chains and their nobles with fetters of iron, to execute on them this written judgment. Dishonor have all his saints. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Sing to him a new song. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
All right, hey, shalom, shalom, sir, brother, shemak. I want to first start by giving all the glory, infinite praises unto Yahweh, Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashim, Recha Kadash. Double honors to our teachers, the apostles, the elders, and great millstone, who teach real well and oversee this tabernacle of David. Shalom to the sincere Akim that's pushing and teaching his truth across four corners of the earth and giving all the diligence to do so. All right, I just want to touch on this topic at hand. You know, this is a good scene in the movie Birth of a Nation. Referring to, you know, the Israelites, you know, basically coming and get revenge, man. Recompense unto the elites, unto the rulers of this wicked world, man. Unto the rulers of the reason why, you know, our families are broken up, you know, even though it's all the Lord's doing, okay? But the reason why gentrification is going on, working 50, 60 hours a week, you know? The reason why we're in slavery, man, our wicked rulers that are our oppressors that are ruling over us, man, and hold themselves not guilty. You know, they really think they're innocent, man. And we're coming to a time with prophecy, and this is prophecy, man. The elites and kings and the wicked rulers of this world, man, are going to get their revenge, man. Are going to get their punishment, basically, by the hands of the black Spanish and Native Americans, okay? All right, this is prophecy, man. All right. So I'm gonna touch on that chapter that, you know, that was quoted here in the movie, cause it was powerful and it was strong, man. So let me first get Psalms 148:14, just to acknowledge and refer to who the saints truly are. Okay, it says this is Psalms 148:14. He also exalted the horn of his people. See, that's him exalting us, putting that spirit, the spirit of the Lord, back into his people. You got the prophets being back here on highways and byways, teaching the people there to come back to the Lord, teaching people to repent, okay? While the Lord is near, you know. It says he also exalted the horn of his people, the praise of all his saints, even of the children of Israel, okay? So that even is like saying indeed the children of Israel, okay? That's who the saints are. The saints are not any other nation, not the Arabs, not the Africans, not the East Indians, none of that, man. The black, Spanish, and Native Americans are Israelites, okay? That's who the chapter's referring to, man. That's who, that term's referring to in the movie, man. Okay, it says that people near unto him, praise ye the Lord, okay? As you heard it in the movie, man, in the clip I just played. All right, so I can start at verse 5, really. I saw the verse 5. All right, it reads, Psalms 149, verse 5. Let the saints be joyful in glory. Let them sing aloud upon their beds. Let the high praises of the Most High be in their mouth and a two-edged sword in their hand. See, our sword is not carnal. The weapons of our warfare are not carnal. Our sword are these scriptures, simple and plain. These scriptures cut deep, man. We bringing out these scriptures, you can feel it in the spirit. You know, whether that's good and bad on somebody else, man, you're going to feel it. You're going to feel the power of these scriptures, man. This is not a regular book. This is a book that told you what happened in the past, what is going on now, and what is going to happen in the future. And that's prophecy right there, man. All right. History and prophecy. Okay. Verse 7, to execute vengeance upon the heathen and punishments upon the people. See, vengeance is coming, you know, by the hands of Israelites. Okay. This topic has been brought up at last camp, you know. It, of course, prophecy, of course, but, you know, just binding, getting the elites of this world, you know, into chains, man. You're going to slavery. The heathen are going to slavery, man. Punishment is coming. All right. So I'm gonna continue on. Verse 8. This is the point. This is the point right here when he said in the movie clip, to bind their kings with chains and their nobles with fetters of iron. See, this is physical. This is going to happen, man. This is prophecy. You know, you elites of this world, you damn Rothschilds and Rockefeller families, all the connected families. You know, you got the princes of England and stuff, man. Hey, those elites of the rulers of this world, this wicked kingdom, man, these wicked kingdoms, you know, hey, you're going to get binded up with chains, man, nobles and fetters of iron. Verse 9, to execute upon them the judgment written. This is already written. This is already predestined to happen. No, it's no stopping it. Because we know you're going to try to hide in your bunkers, and I'm going to get that scripture as well. You're going to try to hide from judgment. You can't hide from the Lord, man. It's no hiding from the Lord. You're going to get it, you know? This is not our rest, man. This is not it. This is not life, man. Okay? For the Israelites out there, you know, you sincere, you know, listeners and sincere believers, all right? This honor have all his saints. Praise you the Lord, okay? Let me also grab Jeremiah. You know why I can't, why it's on my mind. It's Jeremiah chapter 16. I'm going to start at verse 14. Yes, sir. I'm going to start at 14. All right. So this is Jeremiah chapter 16, verse 14. Just to further bring home the point. It says, therefore, behold, the days come, saith the Lord, that it shall no more be said, the Lord liveth, that brought up the children of Israel out of the land of Egypt. See, that time has passed. Okay. We understand that was a great deliverance, but he's going to bring an even better deliverance, man. Imagine that, you know, an even better deliverance, man. So this is verse 15. But the Lord liveth that brought up the children of Israel from the land of the north. Mm. And is not America the melting pot of Israelites, man? Just look around. Everybody understands or has some type of sense when it comes to who the true Israelites are, who the true people of the Bible are in North America, man, in Babylon the Great. You see where the Lord is putting a strong spirit in this wicked kingdom. That's gonna bring even more greater deliverance and even greater judgment on this wicked kingdom, man, which is Babylon the Great. Okay, and these other nations are definitely gonna get touched, man. Of course, in the battle of Armageddon, this gathering the mountain of troops, you know, in Yahweh Shapat, okay, the Valley of Jehoshaphat over there in the Middle East, it's gonna go down over there too. All right, it's going to be beautiful, man. It says that I brought up the children of Israel from the land of the north and from all the lands whither he have driven them. And I will bring them again to their land that I have gave unto their fathers. See, that region over there in the Middle East, man, it must get destroyed because that's our land over there. Not that little piece of land, you know, that's labeled Jerusalem, Israel. Okay, that entire area over there, man, that's ours, man. Okay, and it's going to be taken back. Is it not spoken about with Daniel chapter 7, verse 18, that the saints shall take the kingdom? Hey, man, it's going to get real out here, man. That spiritual powers right there, man. Okay, verse 16. This is spiritual powers as well, too, and it touches on the bunkers. Okay, so this is Jeremiah chapter 16, verse 16. Behold, I will send for many fishers, saith the Lord, and they shall fish them. Okay, we're fishing right now. You know, we're planting the seed. Okay, from the scriptures. You know, ultimately from the spirit of the Lord. Okay, and whoever it catches is going to catch. You know, this is the bait. You know, we sending out the bait, man, through the scriptures. All right, it says, after will I send for many hunters, and they shall hunt them from every mountain. Okay, in the mountain is referring to governments, man. We're going to be getting binding up chains with the kings and nobles of these other nations, man. These other governments. And from every hill and out of the holes of the rocks. Because we understand with the elites, man, with the wicked rulers of this world, they have technology advances where they can hide, you know, the bunkers and they're going to go up to space and all types. You know, they're going to try to do all types of things, man. And then Lord's going to allow them to escape the judgment. You know, for them to be the first fruits of slavery. You know, let that sink in, man. First fruits of slavery, man. All right. Let me get Revelation chapter 6. Hopefully this is it. Yeah, this is Revelation chapter 6, verse 15. And the kings of the earth, and the great men, and the rich men, and the chief captains, and the mighty men, and every bond man, and every fear man, hid themselves in the dens and in the rocks of the mountains. See, people are going to try to hide from the Lord. People are going to try to hide from judgment and think they're good. They're going to really, they're going to truly and sincerely believe that they're safe, man, safe and sound. Hell no, bro. Hell no, man. This is Revelation chapter 6, verse 16. And said to the mountains and the rocks, following us, Slaki, following us and hide us from the face of him that sitteth on the throne and from the wrath of the Lamb. Who is that Lamb? Yahweh Shah, man. Our deliverer. Okay? That's what we're going to be screaming out to Yahweh Shah, because he's coming back. The Lord is coming back, man. He's sending his son back for his elect, man. Okay? For his elect. That's what it's all about. The elect, those sincere believers, man. Everybody's not going to make it on the first go around. All right? Let me get Daniel chapter 7, verse 18, since I mentioned it. Daniel chapter 7, verse 18. But the saints of the Most High shall take the kingdom and possess the kingdom forever, even forever and ever. See, we're truly chasing and pushing towards eternal life. No more dying, man. No more tears. Hold on, let me get it, man. Because that's what all this suffering that we're going through now, it is light affliction. It's going to be worth it, man. We're going to look back and be like, man, hey, it was a piece of cake. You know, that's nothing, you know. And to our flesh, you know, it may seem, you know, weary and gloomy right now. Man, hey, it's not going to compare to the kingdom as spoken about in Romans chapter 8, verse 18. All right? We got to get revenge on these people, man. This is Revelation chapter 21, verse 3. And I heard a great voice out of the heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of God, of the Most High Power, is with men. And he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and the Most High himself shall be with them and be their power. And the Most High shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. So that, hey, those words suck to the wicked rulers of this earth, man. Those words suck, man, that the Israelites gonna have eternal life. You know, because, man, look at their kingdom, man. You died 100 years old. You know, they live out to 80, 90. You know what I'm saying? You know, they live their so-called best life, you know. Okay? But, hey, what is 100 years to eternity, man? You know? That's nothing, bro. A few seconds. That's why this kingdom cannot compare to our kingdom, man. No more crying, no more struggling, man. You know, no more. When you look at our people on Mars, man, you just look around, period. You know, homeless people, Jake killing each other like it's nothing. You know, just straight hate towards the curses are real, man. Okay, all these things are gonna be, you know, revived. You know, our spirit's gonna be, the Israelite spirit is gonna be revived, man. And it's being revived right now through his men, through the Lord's men, through the men of the Lord right now, pushing, you know, with true diligence, man. Okay. And let me see if I want any. No, I feel like that's all I had, man. You know, just to you know, land back off the clip, cause I love this clip, man. This is exhorting for me. This is it motivates me. You know, I love watching this clip. You know, it truly never gets old. You know, and it's all about the saints, man. It's all about those upright ones within the nation of Israel, man. The Black Spans, Native Americans who are humble enough to receive this truth. You know, your reward is coming, and it's going to come, man. We just gotta wait. You know, and be patient and wait for it, man. Wait for the Lord to come back and redeem us, man. All right. Pertaining to Zephaniah chapter 3, verse 8. Of course, there's more scriptures on it, but, you know, the one that pops in my mind. You know, and just basically, man, just prophesying. I just quickly wanted to prophesy against these elites, man, that they're going into slavery. Simple as that. You know, and I end the lesson off with that. You know, Revelation chapter 13, verse 9, real quick. Just to let it be known, even if it sounds like a broken record, man. Revelation chapter 13, verse 9. If any man have an ear, let him hear. He that liveth into captivity shall go into captivity. He that killeth with the sword must be killed with the sword. Here's the patience and the faith of the saints. Hey, that goes exactly what I was just touching on, man. All in fewer words. That's why it's best is to bring out the scriptures and not babble too much at the mouth. Because the scriptures bring it straight to the point. all these nations that had us in captivity, all these nations that benefiting off our slavery, you're going to slavery, man. All these nations that came together, because Psalms 83 speaks about it. All these nations came together, man, with NATO having a meeting, having these government meetings. We don't have nobody to represent us, man. With all these countries meeting, man, coming up with all type of strategic ways and wicked ways to keep us down, to keep the Black, Spanish, Native Americans at a lower state, you're going to slavery, and you will be killed with a sword. And this is our faith, and this is our, we got to keep the patience, because this is predestined to happen. We just got to wait for it to happen, man. Okay? All right? So, you know, Lord willing, you know, this lesson was edifying and exhorting, you know, for the sincere believers out there. I want to end off by giving all the glory and for the praises unto Yahweh, Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashim, Rakakadash. Double honor to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone, who teach you with wedding overseas tabernacle of David. Peace, love, and safety to the hopefully elect and their families. With that, I'll say Shalom. Waffle ball, a bodba ball, keep the faith.